is we have our CDs album that we put out in October, and they're out there on the table, and they're free. So woo! Please take one and give a listen. We're going to do a lot of those songs tonight. This is so cool. Thank you for having us, Kathy, and this is a great space.
Yay. I'm really
honored to be here. It's a lot different from playing in the rowdy bars, yeah. But you could still get a cocktail, I understand. So, yes. Yeah, you ready?
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. This is a song about Calicoon here.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So in case you didn't know, that was about Calicoon, and that's kind of our home base. We actually live on the Pennsylvania side of the river, but our businesses and our lives are in Calicoon, and it's been an inspiration for a lot of the songs that I write. But this next song is actually about my husband, Dan, and he's the other inspiration. For good or bad. This one's a good one. If we have a fight, I write about it, but... but this is a good one. This is not the poison of the love. And it's true. Oh.
Thank you.
That's Dan in a nutshell. And so this next song, I always have to explain that I wrote it before I met Dan. I never really performed it, but it was, it's about, it's pre-meeting each other.
Pre-Dan.
BD, one might say.
When you hear the words, you'll know why. Drummer who's amazing because sometimes he plays bass with us. He has a stand-up bass and a little bass, and he's got all kinds of drums, and he is learning to play cello right now. So we might have a cello in the band. And he's also a singer-songwriter and a guitar player and on and on. And Pat Churchill here is so great with being, you know, instrumental on our album. Really, he really made us sound so much better, so thank you. And Dan Brinkerhoff is my husband and lead instrumentation on the fiddle. Yeah. Sometimes he plays the ute, but I don't know. I'm going to bring it tonight.
Not tonight.
And sings. Sometimes he doesn't want to sing the songs I write, but he does.
None of those things are true. And don't forget to
introduce
yourself. And
I'm Joanne, his wife.
And my two dogs, the two dogs.
And Maddie and Pete over there.
Maddie and Pete.
They're actually the muse behind the music, actually, because if you know, when I walk them, I get a lot of inspiration for songs. And then about, I don't know, for about 2 weeks this winter, a week before last, I didn't go out because it was raining and snowing and all that stuff, and I didn't go out. And I was wondering why I hadn't even written a note or a word or anything. And then it was because I realized that it was because I wasn't walking the dogs. Because as soon as I got back outside again, I started writing another song. So, hey. Thank you, doggies. All right. So
hey,
this
Maddie
next song,
and Petey.
I hope they're behaving themselves.
They're
I can't
perfect
sing
angels.
So this next song is actually a true story that I wrote out of desperation from listening to one of our neighbor's sad stories. I didn't know what to do with being dumped on, so I wrote this song.
It's a hard reality.
Thank you.
quiet you down. So, all right. After that song, we have to do a kind of happy
upper
song.
Upper.
Yeah, it's not really happy.
This one will take it even further down.
You can describe this one.
Well, it's a made-up song, but we went out west 6 years in a row driving to Arizona, and we always would go through Texas, and Texas had so many stories.
Mm-hmm.
And so this is kind of a lot
Texas
of those.
Texas has a whorehouse in it.
A what?
Say that again.
Texas has a whorehouse in it. Lord,
the best
have mercy
ones.
On
the,
our
the
soul.
Best little one?
That's true.
Yeah.
Well, this is not about that. But this is about a guy from Texas.
Yeah, it's about a guy from Texas. It's not about a whorehouse.
Sorry.
Yeah, all right.
We haven't done this for a while.
Okay, ready?
Thank you.
still say if I own Texas and I own Carolina, Texas.
He actually wears them in the house.
Oh, there's a song.
What if I did? All at the same time.
A new one every day. But he came home with this one, and this fit me exactly.
Of course it does.
Yeah.
That's an accident, right?
Sorry?
That was an accident, right?
Well,
no,
I'm
he
sure.
He's like, this is about her size. It's perfect.
The dogs have some too.
Oh!
All right. Well, we're going to do a new song. This one is kind of less than a month old. And this was actually, I guess if I had to describe the theme of this song, it's probably, I would say it's climate change. But it was actually inspired by a local art show that we went to. It was really amazing. I'm not,
I didn't even know.
Anyway, the words speak for themselves.
Okay, sorry.
I'm gonna let Pat introduce this song. I always jump on his parade. Okay. Thank you.
that's the first time we performed that.
It is.
Wow. Just a dream.
And this is, do we do this one on our album? I'm not sure.
Yeah, Teach Me to Power.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, this one's on the our CD. This is another story I wrote. Dan and I, in the morning, we spend a lot of time having coffee and just talking, and we tell each other stories about growing up and when we were crazy teenagers and all the things we did. And he's got some great stories. He's full of material. And then after we get up, I always like jot down some things that he's told me to that eventually become songs.
You know, I have this friend, Nick Broden, who's a heart surgeon, and most of us know him, but he was talking about, I told him that I walked across the state of Texas with a three-speed bicycle I bought for $20 that had two flat tires, and he said, you know, you could have been an MD like me, but you took a wrong turn. And walked through Texas instead, so.
But look at all the songs that came out of it.
That was a pretty bad wrong turn, I guess.
So this is actually totally true.
All right.
Thank you.
bold.
He's an amazing French speaker, Matt.
Ah, salut.
They have French, they have courthouses down there.
Of course they do, I know.
Fantastique.
I never lived that down my
That's
life.
What he was really going after.
Of course it was.
Forget about learning French.
Anything to talk to me, I'm talking back.
So, okay, a more serious song here. This is about people that are marginalized. I wrote this one during the, there were the riots a few years ago when George Floyd was killed and everybody was out in the streets. And anyway, that's where this came from, but it can be applied to any time, any day.
Thank you.
Yeah, we have another new song here. You guys are our guinea pigs here. We're bringing out the new stuff.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, because we intend to put out another album next fall. And I already got 6 new ones. And so we'll get working on them this summer when we start really playing a lot more. But anyway, see if you like them. This song was inspired by my dad, who, like most people, write about their parents, and it's always something kind of sweet, but we're boys in love.
Bring it.
No, my father was great. I love my father, but he was a very complicated man, and he had a lot of poison love in him, too. So he grew up in a really, really, really tough times and in a really, really tough area. Anyway, he told me lots of stories, like Dan tells me lots of stories, and this comes from that. So, COVID time, and I have a real job because nobody makes money from music. So the real job went in the toilet, and then it was like, oh, well, now what? And so that's where this song came from. I actually found out that I really liked it. And then when I had to go back to work, I was really upset about it. So. Fiddles here. We got one more song until we take a break.
She's like, girl.
Okay, so this song.
Bring it in, people, bring it in.
Is actually a man's voice singing a verse and a, it's the woman singing the chorus.
In the blink of an eye.
I wrote this song about men who just won't take their wives out for a good time, or they don't, you know, they just want to come home and hang out and watch TV and that kind of stuff.
True that.
None of these people is, you know. What?
Show me the time.
Can you see that?
It's in the back of his.
No. Really?
It's in his trunk.
Back home and get your shit. That's right, drive
home. Call your wife, Patty.
She's like, what are you calling for?
Unlike people that do cover songs, he just can't go on his phone and get the music. You know. Show me a good time.
Thank you.
you. You're poisoned love, and you're coming back for a second set. You're going to lose 10 of our CDs. They're free.
So don't go anywhere. They're coming back in a few minutes, and you can take the time to try out some of these sequin dresses. This is your only chance. This is your only chance.
You guys are so good. You're being very good, Maddie.
In our entire set, which we did not write, but it's the culmination of all of Dan's French experiences.
Yeah, actually, I can speak pretty good.
Yeah. So he's going to sing it in French.
All right. All right. Oui, oui, bien sûr.
Thank you.
a French song.
That is Catskills. Isn't that right?
Playing the jangle part there.
Yeah, he actually learned, he can play it the real gypsy jazz way. And I tried to play it and it was like, no way I'm playing that. So, someday I'll work with him on it. All right, this next song this came in a dream, actually. It really did. And it was, I wrote it on the night that David Crosby died.
Oh, God.
And I always loved his music, and he was, he was a jerk, but he was, he was a,
talented
jerk. A very inspirational songwriter to me. And
me too.
I had written, you know, not long before, read one of his biographies. Anyway, I went to bed that night and said, boy, I wish I could write a song like you. And I didn't write a song like him, but I did write a song. So I think it was inspired by him.
Wow.
And I like to think that anyway. Waking without you.
Thank you.
know, firm, Kathy?
Yes.
Firm, tight?
Firm, tight schedule. You get to play as long as you'd like.
Oh, okay. Cool. All right.
Yep.
Okay. So here's a song that I wrote with for a good friend. Well, sort of. Who was going through a really bad time. And I can't say who it is because everybody probably knows.
Keep track of the time going by, and we have two more songs from Poison Love.
Okay.
And you know what? Give it up.
Yeah.
And you know, if you haven't had a chance to visit the dogs, be sure to say hi.
All right, you're forcing us to make a choice here. Okay, we're gonna do the song from which is the title of our album. Called Wild Ride.
Wild Ride!
And
woo!
That song was about getting older I didn't say old, I said older. And a lot of people not wanting to go out anymore because they don't drive at night or they're too tired or their legs hurt.
Not like us.
Not you guys.
You're preaching to the choir.
I am preaching to the choir. But it's fun. It was a fun song to write and a fun song to sing and play. And Pat really got into it. And I think you got to take a little LSD when you hear this song.
Well, you've
already got the green dress on. Take the next step.
Party favors.
Yeah, we just have to give Pat a minute here to change guitars, but yeah. Has anyone seen that? It's like a Woodstock poster, but all the people in it are about 85, 90 years old.
Oh, God.
And they're all like, you know.
I was once at Woodstock.
Like really bad shape and everything, and they're.
They're not naked, are they?
They're not naked.
Thank God. Whoa.
I hear a little ageism happening.
Whoa.
Yeah. But if you had to, like, redo that. That photo right now, that's kind of what it would look like. So that's kind of what the song is about.
Looking old at Woodstock.
Anyway, while Pat's getting ready, we want to just thank again Kathy and the Delaware Valley Opera Company.
Thank you so much.
And I just think that's like such a gift to have a place like this in the middle of the country and in the middle of the winter and just really, really nice.
The middle of nowhere. You
in the middle of nowhere.
With sequins.
The middle of nowhere is everywhere.
That's true.
Yeah. It's definitely somewhere. Yeah. And we hope them, we wish them a lot of success for their coming year, and we hope
thank you
that we're invited back if we didn't. We didn't really go over the top with the sequins.
That was good.
Anyway, check us out online for our schedule. I'm always putting up stuff. And we get a busy month this February. I don't know why, for whatever reason. We're like all over the place. But then we're kind of quiet for a while. So.
Kind of quiet.
Quiet could be good.
You. Thank you.
We got one more, right?
Yes,
yeah,
sure.
Right.
So now we have to choose. I'm going to
leave it up to Dan here.
Bring it on home.
Train wreck.
Or we can
do
train wreck.
Yeah. Oh,
my goodness, there's so many songs.
There's overwhelming demand for train wreck.
All right, train wreck.
Okay. Oh!
He
had to have his moment, yes.
Oh, okay. Damn. You're not going to get to hear the rest of our new songs. Okay.
Well, it's up to you.
You're going to have his back.
Of course.
All right.
Actually, we're just not going to leave. There's
okay, so Trainwreck was another song written in Calicoon, actually on the train tracks. My grandson would, we'd go for walks with the dogs during the day, and his bright idea was, let's walk along the train tracks. And my soles of my shoes actually ripped from walking on those tracks.
Whoa.
And anyway, it was a train wreck, and that's where this song came from.
Okay.
But a metaphor.
A metaphorical train.
How old are your grandkids?
The one that was on the walk with me was, at the time he was 11.
11.
He's going on 12 now. He's a tween.
He's a tween.
Jen Alpha.
Grandson.
Yeah.
My first, so that's kind of
cool. Awesome.
Is it Jen Alpha?
Yeah, he's Jen Alpha, don't you know?
Okay, are we ready? Thanks again, everybody. We're Poison Lava.
Yeah.
I appreciate you coming out. And the weather was no excuse to not come out tonight.
No, so. It wasn't.
It
train to stop.
Oh, yeah. So, if you'd like your shot up here on the stage, tomorrow we have an open mic.
Open mic.
Tomorrow afternoon from 3 until 6, an open mic right here at Arts Nest. Safe home, everyone. Be well. That was a good one.
Yeah, if you guys don't have a CD player, because a lot of people don't, you can stream on any platform. We're on there. I don't even know what a platform is, but they're on there.
And you're streaming on it, whatever it is.
Just a second. And.